Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the different cases of an accelerating lift. So let's get started. So today's topic is about a man standing in an accelerating lift. So before we get into the different cases that we have, first let me discuss briefly about frame of reference. So frame of reference or reference frame is simply a coordinate system relative to which the state of a body is determined. Now this state can be its position, or velocity, or acceleration of the body. Next, we have two types of reference frame. One is inertial reference frame, whose acceleration is zero. So if we consider a reference frame, a 3D reference frame, which is basically a three-dimensional coordinate system. So this reference frame will have acceleration equal to zero. So this reference frame might be at rest, or it might be moving with an uniform velocity. So such reference frame or such coordinate system, we can call it inertial reference frame. Inertial reference frame obeys the laws of motion. The second type that we have is non-inertial reference frame. So in case of non-inertial reference frame, the acceleration of the reference frame is non-zero and it does not obey the laws of motion. So again, if we draw our three-dimensional coordinate system, that is x, y, z axis, then this time the coordinate system or the reference frame will have a non-zero acceleration. So the cases that we will discuss in this lecture will be with respect to inertial reference frame, okay, because it obeys the laws of motion. So our first case is a lift moving up with acceleration a. So let me first draw the lift. And here is our man. Now the first case says that the lift is moving up with acceleration a, right? Now let us mark the different forces acting on this man. So the first one is the weight of the man, mg, downwards. Now this man is standing inside the lift. So we can say the man is in contact with the floor of the lift, right? So the floor will offer some normal reaction on the man. Let's say the normal reaction on this man is R. Now if we draw the FBD of this man, like let's say this is the body and one force is acting on this body downwards, that is mg, and the other is the reaction force upwards, that is R. Now this body is moving up with the lift, right? So this body will move up with the same acceleration as the lift, that is A. Now we can apply the second law of motion, right? That is net force acting on this body is mass into acceleration. So net force is nothing but R minus mg, that is equal to ma. So the reaction force will be mg plus a. Okay. So the reaction force that is that the fluid offers will be m times g plus a. So this is the apparent weight. This is the apparent weight of the man standing inside the lift. So clearly here the apparent weight that is R is greater than mg, or we can say is greater than the original weight of the man. That is mg. Now for the second case, we have lift moving down with acceleration a less than g. So here the lift is moving down with acceleration a. So a less than g. So again, if we draw the FBD of the man, again there are two forces, mg and R, acting on the body, and this time the acceleration of the body is in the downward direction, right? So again, net force will be mass times acceleration. Now this time net force is mg minus R. Why? Because the acceleration of the body is in the downward direction, so this downward force has to be greater than R to make the body accelerate downwards. So we have written mg minus R is equal to ma. So this time R will be equal to mg minus ma, or we can write mg minus a. Right? Now this condition is there, a less than g. Now if a less than g, then R will be positive, right? R will be positive because a less than g means g minus a will be greater than 0. So R is positive. So this means that there will be some reaction force offered by the floor on this man, right? Some positive reaction force offered by this floor on this man. So this time apparent weight, we write it down, apparent weight R is less than the original weight of the man, which is mg, right? Because R this time is mg minus ma, right, which is less than mg. So now we have our final case where the lift is moving down with acceleration a greater than equal to g. So here the condition is acceleration a is greater than or equal to g. So here again we have our lift, and this time first let me consider the case where acceleration a is equal to g, okay, and it is moving down, the lift is moving down. So this is the case. Now again, if I draw the FBD of the man, mg downwards, R is in the upward direction, and here we have acceleration of the man is g in the downward direction. So here again the net force is mg minus R, that will be equal to mass times acceleration, that is m into the acceleration is g. So in this case the R or the reaction force will be 0. Now let's take our second case where acceleration is greater than g, right? Now if the acceleration is greater than g, then we'll have our FBD as and downward acceleration which is greater than g. So mg minus R will be equal to ma, right? Or R is equal to m g minus a. Now this time acceleration is greater than g, right? So we can write g minus a will be less than 0, or r will be less than 0, that is r is negative, right? Which is practically not possible. So what is happening here is, once the lift is moving down or accelerating downwards with acceleration greater than g, the lift and the man will get detached, right? The man will no longer be in contact with the floor of the lift. So the man will have an acceleration g downwards, which means the man will freely fall. Under gravity, and the lift will move down with its own acceleration a. Okay, so this time, if we draw the FBD of the body, the acceleration of the man or the acceleration of the body will be g and not equal to a. Okay? Because the acceleration of the man here is not a. This is the acceleration of the lift. So while drawing the FBD of the man, we have to consider the acceleration of the man, which is g, because the man is freely falling under gravity. So here also the reaction force will be 0, right? Mg minus r will be equal to mg, which means r equal to 0. So this FBD that we have drawn earlier is wrong. Okay, why? Because the acceleration of the man is g and not equal to a. So we are drawing the FBD of the man, so you have to consider the acceleration of the man, which is g. So this is correct. So for the third case, where acceleration is greater than or equal to g, we can write the reaction force is coming out to be 0. That means there will be no contact between the man and the floor of the lift. So the man will move separately and the lift will move separately. So this condition is also called weightlessness. Okay, because here the apparent weight, which is r, is 0 for this case. For a greater than or equal to g, the apparent weight r is 0. So which means the man will feel that his weight is 0. So this was all. I hope it was clear, and you can check out the description box for this document. So thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next video.